Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Confidence is never a question when it comes to wide receivers, and these two are no different. It's Fitzgerald's Cardinals going up against Smith's 49ers. So with that, let's get you out to the stadium. Standing by tonight are our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the home of Super Bowl 50, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Tonight, we've got a great Sunday night matchup between the Arizona Cardinals and the San Francisco 49ers. And we say hi again, everybody. Brandon Godden here as we count down to kickoff. I turn to my partner, that's Charles Davis. And Charles, Larry pointed out in the open, we've got a pretty good matchup of wide receivers here this afternoon, don't we?
And those guys have such a big impact on the game nowadays. We know it's a throwing game, but the guys who can go up and get it, the guys who can break tackles after the catch and make bigger plays, oh yeah, they love spotlight as well. They want the football, they want the attention.
Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. Now it's Ellington to return. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. The Cardinals and Carson Palmer looking to bounce back from their Week 3 loss to Buffalo, and in particular, Charles, Palmer wants to bounce back. Four interceptions on their last four drives.
And we know it's a passing league, but if you can't run the ball at all and get some balance, look out. Buffalo prepared, and I think Carson Palmer threw those interceptions in the last four possessions, correct? Yep. So they're trying to battle back from a big deficit and couldn't quite get there.
And he threw the ball 50 times total, completed 26 of them. First down, it's Palmer, and his first pass is incomplete. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver, and that'll make it second and 10. And certainly one of the mainstays in this offense is the crafty veteran, L. Fitz.
Love the way you phrased it, crafty. This guy knows how to get open and catch the football.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Second and 10. It's Palmer again. And this one complete to Jermaine Gresham. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Give him 8 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker. Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
So on fourth down, here's Ryan Quigley now to kick this one away. Back deep, Jeremy Curley. So not much to speak of scoring-wise in this first quarter of play. Nothing, nothing, our score. We're back to Santa Clara after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Godden, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals in possession of the football. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. Now the punter, Ryan Quigley, is on in his fourth season out of Boston College. Here's Curley. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. As we start to get a look at this Arizona defense, how about the interception this past week, albeit in a loss, that Peterson had?
He's just simply special, isn't he? Look, he's been 5 years in the league, been to the Pro Bowl five times, three times first-team All-Pro. One of those five times he went as a kick returner. There's not much he can't do on the field, and that interception kind of summed it up. Acrobatic, athletic, sensational.
First down, Gabbert. He's got time. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Gabbert now to throw on first down. He's got his guy. It's Patton over the middle. It'll be a gain of four, and it'll bring up a second down. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. Second down now after the pass completion. Gabbert now on second down. And caught by Curley. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 5 yards on the pickup. And that is going to set up a third and one. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Completed pass on second down. Now it's third down as the defense looks for the stop. On third and one, here's Gabbert. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. No gain at all on the play there, and that brings up fourth. Well, if you're going to pass on third and one, you better get a first down if you complete it. They completed it, but no gain.
The aiming point has to be beyond the first down marker where you throw the ball. Third and one, you can have anything that's even close to the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, you run the risk of what we just saw there, not getting the first down.
That's on target, but it's no good. He had it online, but it came up just shy of the crossbar, and this will remain a scoreless game.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement, so now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
So out now come the Cardinals. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Down 11 yards on the pickup, and it'll give the Cardinals a first down. Palmer on first down. He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. 15 yards through the air and a first down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And we are back here. I'm Brandon Gunn alongside Charles Davis. So the offense takes a timeout. And now we're set to get going.
Simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. Chandler Catanzaro, we know he has some leg, hit a 60-yarder in week three. That's a long for him in his career and the longest kick this year in the NFL.
And it doesn't ease all the pain from missing the field goal that would have won the game against New England in the season opener. But 60 yards, that's awfully impressive.
And he also punted. Drew Butler was injured, their normal punter, so he pulled double duty.
Well, you know what they say in the NFL, the more you can do.
The more you can do what?
The longer you can stay in the league.
Yeah, makes sense. Now after the made field goal, Catanzaro to boot this one away on the kickoff. Returnable here for Davis. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So we've reached halftime. All we have to show for the first half, a lone field goal. 3-0 our score. As we send you cross country to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando with our halftime report, here's Larry Ridley.
Thanks, Brandon. Thanks, Charles. And welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The 49ers right now have a time of possession advantage, but it has not led them to taking control of this game. The Cardinals look like they'll be in this game for four quarters. All right, let's roll those moving pictures. Cardinals have it at the 44. Here's a quick pass and completion to Larry Fitzgerald. And he ends up at the 29-yard line before he's stopped on the play. But they end up coming away with just three on the drive. So that'll do it for us at the EA Sports Studio. We're going back under the lights for the second half of this Sunday night matchup.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Here comes the 49ers offensive unit as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. They come out here with a 0 on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, Are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution, or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they thought they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target.
Brandon, while we have a quick second here, can we talk about the Ravens a little bit?
Sure.
Because they're off to a 3-0 start. Remember the rough season they had last year with all the injuries. And they're getting a lot of those guys back and playing at a really high level. Joe Flacco from his knee injury, Steve Smith Sr. from the Achilles, Terrell Suggs from an Achilles, and it's all coming together early for Baltimore.
They always seem to be in the mix. Big win, although it was in Jacksonville, is now 0-3. Big road win this past week.
Remember in preseason, Jacksonville is one of those very trendy picks to compete for the playoffs.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
And that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. First and 10, Gabbard. Smith catches left side. Give him 11 on the gain there. And the 49ers are going to get a first. Here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. So here we go, first and 10 now. Back to throw. This one complete, right side to McDonald. And he's brought down. It'll go as a gain of 12. And it'll be first down, 49ers. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw. On the left side, it's McDonald. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Two receivers left, one to the right. He's back to throw. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
They'll look to throw, and he finds McDonald, and he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. He'll look to throw. Penalty marker is down here. So the defensive holding penalty here, Charles.
You get outside of 5 yards downfield and you get grabby with an offensive player, the flag will come out every time.
So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. On the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with third down upcoming. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. So the field goal, and now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to potentially send us to overtime. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Now it's Ellington to return. Oh, what a move. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Johnson, and he's brought down. So four quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Nothing between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. Returnable here for Davis. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Here's the Cardinals defense as they head out to set up shop. And last time out, they gave up the chip shot field goal, but obviously could have been worse than that. I think they felt pretty good about only giving up three.
No doubt about it. Anytime an offense gets into the red zone, the thinking naturally for the defense is, okay, 3 points. We're going to give up three here, but let's make it no more than that. They met their goal.
On the other side, though, the offense, they weren't very happy.
No, because there's an opportunity. Once you get to the red zone, you're not thinking about kicking a field goal. You're thinking about how do you get it into the end zone, and when you don't, you walk off the field feeling a little bit of failure on that drive.
Yeah, who will have the better feeling at the end of this drive? Now a run with Hyde. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. Second down following the run. They run it again with Hyde. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. They get five out of that one, and it moves the chains. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Alert, alert. Three down.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that will be their third and final in this overtime session. And as they talk it over, we take a break. We'll be right back. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Now the first throw in overtime for Gabbert. Finding time. All kinds of time. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver. And they're going to have a third down.
I'm not quite sure how he wasn't able to hold on to that one in the end zone. A great opportunity lost, but a lot of relief for the defensive guys. When they get into film next week, they're going to want to know what happened. Where was the breakdown that almost allowed a touchdown?
A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and eight. Gabbert surveying the field. Still back there. And able to find Curley. And he's brought down after a good game. Well, how about this? The very, very rare tie that we just witness. Hard to believe.
You don't see it very often. A bonus period of football, yet both teams go home a little bit unsatisfied.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL.